In the mid-1970s, Walt Disney Productions was involved in the biggest theme park they had ever attempted, EPCOT Center.
This is WED Enterprises, a unique design organization established in the early 1950s to plan Disneyland and later Walt Disney World. Today's WED staff includes artists, designers, architects, computer technicians, engineers, and dozens of others working in a harmonic blend of space-age creativity called Imagineering.
Countless drawings, concepts, and ideas were thrown about, trying to create what the Disney property in Florida was originally bought for, Walt's experimental prototype community of tomorrow.
It will be a community of tomorrow that will never be completed, but will always be introducing and testing and demonstrating new materials and new systems. And EPCOT will always be a showcase to the world for the ingenuity and imagination of American free enterprise.
EPCOT was to be divided into two sections, Future World, where World's Fair-like pavilions would be located, and the World Showcase.
This is the World Showcase. Countries from around the world will stand side by side in friendship along the banks of a broad lagoon, symbolic of the waters that bind together the diversified community of man.
Inside Future World, each pavilion would cost a total of $60 million each and required major corporate sponsors to help ease the cost of the pavilions.
Kraft called and said, if you do a pavilion about food, then we'll sign up, because they wanted $60 million for the, or yeah, 30 or 60, I forget which it was. And I guess it was $30 million and we put in $30 million. And so it was, all the pavilions are supposed to come out at $60 million.
A pavilion with a greenhouse showcasing advances for food production in the 21st century was one of the first pavilions to come to life.
The land pavilion, we're talking EPCOT Center here. We're talking this wonderful, huge dream of Walt Disney's, one of his last great dreams. And shortly after I came off of the assignment with America Sings, I began to hear this buzz about beginning to design pavilions for this whole new project, this experimental prototype community of tomorrow. I was looking around to maybe flex my design muscles a little bit. I collaborated for a time with Tony Baxter on some initial concepts for pavilions that were designed around the themes of the land for the Future World portion of EPCOT. Around 1975, a number of concepts for Future World for EPCOT Center were being massaged. Some of them got as far as full-blown model format, and sponsorship started to come to the forefront. Some of these themes got put on the back burner. The Seas is one, for example, that didn't come forward until after opening day. But one assignment that I got reassigned to with another designer, Rolly Crump, was the land pavilion.
We were all assigned to different pavilions, and I did the life health pavilion first. And then Tony was asked to do the land pavilion. And it wasn't taken very well. So they took Tony off of the land pavilion. So all of a sudden, Claude was put in charge of the land pavilion. And what happened was, he came up, and I was doing the courtyard, and he came up with some stuff and presented it to, I gave my presentation and Claude gave his when we went back to Kraft. And Claude was a great designer, but he wasn't much of a salesman. He'd go, people going here, go over there. And so everybody's just kind of like, what's going on, you know? So Marty finally came to me, he said, Rolly, I'm going to give you the land pavilion, you know? So I said, okay. And he said, but what happened, this is really funny, he said, we have to give him exactly what we presented to him. I said, Marty, you can't build that much square footage for $30 million. I said, it's ridiculous, but we have to do it. We have to do it. And I said, well, I know how we can do it. He says, how's that? I said, just change the scale. In other words, all the drawings were, to a degree, were done. I said, but just change the scale of them. And he said, will that work? And I said, yeah, that'll work.
The pavilion was to contain an enormous greenhouse, showcasing advanced food productions and cultivation.
The land will be your gateway to the major geographic regions of the earth. Here you'll discover the promise and potential that remarkable new agricultural methods are already bringing to food production, including a look at plants which have learned to grow without soil.
The earth and man can be good friends.
Be good friends.
Let's listen so our harvest time will never end.
Well, what happened was I was fortunate to hear about Carl Hodges in Arizona, the environmental lab. And he had his own ecosystem that you actually could walk into. It was a rainforest that rained every day. It was in a building, and it was just the way it was designed. So Carl and I became really close, and so then we started to develop all the hydroponics, which had not been involved at all whatsoever with the land pavilion. And Hinch had a fit because he felt that you couldn't do that, and it wouldn't work. And so we had a lot of doubting Thomas's while I was doing it. And but we were on a roll, we had to do it. So they stepped away from us. But when we got finished with the land pavilion, I personally feel it's more of an EPCOT pavilion than any of the other pavilions, because the tilapia that they grow there, you can eat upstairs in the restaurant, all the vegetables and stuff that they're growing there, you can eat in the restaurant. So I think, you know, the fact that we introduce hydroponics, which is the future in farming, which is environmental farming, I felt really touched on. All the other pavilions are great, but they don't have that bottom line touch that we had with the land. And I feel really sad about what we had with the Life Health Pavilion, because that, I still think that would have been the best one of all. Jeff Burke worked with me on that. We worked very closely on it. And Steve Kirk Scott Hennessy, great team of people. If you get a good team, then you're going to get a good show. And that's basically what happened on the land pavilion. I had a gorgeous team of people I was working with, to where the other pavilions pretty much were handled by one art director. You know, there was not a really what you call a design team working with that.
The entrance was designed to feature the layers of the earth and was done in an artistic way. Upon entering the pavilion, guests were treated to four enormous whimsical hot air balloons representing the four food groups designed by Disney legend Rolly Crump.
The four balloons were the four food groups, and that's basically what it was. And the mother balloon was the mother balloon, and then each one represented the food groups. And then now that it's been redone, we took Michael Eisner over, and he wanted to revamp it. And then he still wanted the balloons, or he didn't want to take out the balloons. So we did a whole series on suns, on the balloons. So the suns became the theme. But the original one was the four food groups.
The first attraction was the pavilion's mainstay, a slow-moving boat ride called Listen to the Land. This attraction would feature animatronic characters and tell the story of the land and its effects on the human population. Several high-resolution 35mm films showing various farms and harvest skills were shown. The main event for the attraction was a trip through an actual greenhouse that would provide food for many of EPCOT's restaurants, including its own rotating restaurant, The Garden Grill. In addition, a 20-minute film entitled Symbiosis was shown to highlight man and nature living in harmony. The third attraction was a whimsical look at good nutrition, done in a cabaret style called the Kitchen Cabaret.
Basically, Kitchen Cabaret was given to Scott and Steve and Jeff, and to come up with a show about food in a humorous way. And they did a beautiful job on that.
Imagineer Jeff Burke remembers.
I enjoyed working with Rolly and his whole heritage of Disney with whimsy and fun, and also the idea of craft that has sponsored so many aspects of music in the public domain, whether it is on television or live concerts or what have you. They had one particular concern in mind at that time for the opening of this pavilion, for the land pavilion, and that was the message of nutrition. This is a message that seems fairly dry, and basically at that time the prevalent thought was getting a balanced diet from the four food groups. That of course has since changed, and I'm sure will change time and time again, but we took our cue from that basic premise, and around that we built a show called The Kitchen Cabaret. So again, I'm back in my own favorite milieu, which is a small cabaret musical review utilizing audio animatronic characters. One of the most fun things to do with an audio animatronic character is to take it and do something that an actor cannot do. You cannot get a broccoli to sing. You cannot get an eggplant to sing. You cannot get a basket of fruit to harmonize. But in Kitchen Cabaret, we got that to happen. When we approached the idea of showcasing this balanced diet and nutrition and food, and we were surrounded by Future World, we had the decision to make. Do we go to outer space? Do we do the Jetsons? Do we do that kind of approach? Because we want to make it as entertaining and as fun and sort of caricatured as possible. Why don't we take a look back at an era that was considered modern and advanced for its time, Art Deco, in the 1930s and 40s, and it still looks very streamlined and wonderful in the kitchen, all of the canisters, the implements, and then introduce the acts within that particular setting. Now, in that setting, we used stuff, musical idioms from the 40s, from the 30s, through the magic of audio animatronics, through the magic of Disney programming, the magic of lighting, special effects. It all came to pass, and that is one of my legacies at Epcot Center, Future World portion, which now, unfortunately, is it's a great memory. Unfortunately, it is part of the extinct attractions. When we approached the idea of Kitchen Cabaret, we took each food group and did sort of a type or style of music. For dairy, we had Showgirls from the Ziegfeld Follies. For the bread group, we had a trio somewhat similar to the Andrews Sisters. For the fruits and vegetables, we did Veggie Veggie Fruit Fruit. Something akin to a Carmen Miranda spectacular. So this whole thing was set in a kitchen of circa the 1930s, 40s. And so our musical idiom somewhat slipped beyond what our audience was really going for.
As time passed, the Little Cabaret Show became a bit dated. While the 1930s was a perfect venue to house this nutrition show, Kraft was now gone, and Nestle wanted a new look for the show.
They wanted that show taken out, so then we decided to To save money, we use the same sets, but we the same show action equipment, but then we just change the sets.
What happened with Food Rocks, when it came in, new characters were introduced. The staging, basically in the kitchen, stayed the same, but things were upgraded. New acts were brought in, more contemporary acts, but the message of good nutrition, balanced diet was maintained.
And then we came up with some real simple characters that were singing and talking about food, and that's when he came up, Jim Steinmeier came up with Food Rocks. So we did each one was a rock star, and then singing their song, like Every Breath I Take, but was done by Every Bite I Take.
The cabaret show was redressed and populated with new stars.
Little Richard, well, we did him as a was it a pineapple? Yeah, I think we did him as a pineapple.
I look to the east, I look to the west, and everywhere the fruit tastes bad to the fruit.
And when he came in to record, he actually recorded his own song for us. And he says, it's funny about time that somebody called me a real fruit. which was really funny, you know.
Today, the land is being cleared for an all-new soaring attraction thrill ride. Low carbs are the thing now, and we had to say goodbye to the cabaret show.
We like to sing about a friend.
Vitamins, A and C, fruit, veggie, fruit, veggie, fruit, fruit, veggie, fruit, fruit.